This week we're going to learn about control structures in JavaScript, and that's if statements and loops. So let's start by creating a project folder for this week. I'm going to go to my XAMPP htdocs folder, which in Windows is C XAMPP htdocs, and inside my 133w folder, I'm going to right-click and create a new folder for week 3, and then inside of the week 3 folder, that's where I'm going to put my files. So let's go and create a new document, and I'm going to save as week 3, and let's call this if.html. So let's start by just creating a straight HTML document. And we'll give it a head with a title, control structures, / if statement. And then a body, which I'm just going to leave empty for now. And we'll close off the HTML and we'll save. So let's go ahead and load that in the browser. CIS 133W week 3 if.html. And then let's go ahead and add some body content. So here's a header line. And let's go ahead and see the first example of an if statement is just if some condition is true, then do some action. And the action can either be a single statement or it can be a block of statements. So let's go ahead and try a simple example. I'm going to put a div box in here. And I'm going to give this an ID, call this the content div. And let's go ahead and find some content that we can put in here. So I'm going to just search for cute animals. Oh, he's cute. Okay, so normally if I was putting this on a website, I would contact the owner of this image and try to get permission, and this actually has a copyright notice on it. Cute puppy. So let's take the cute puppy here. But for teaching purposes, I'm just going to use this image for now. So I'm going to right-click and open image in new tab. Then I'm going to right-click that and save image as. And I'm going to go to my XAMPP folder. htdocs 133w week 3, and then inside week 3 I'm going to right click and create a new folder called images. So I'm going to put all of my images in the images folder, and then I'm going to rename this to be puppy.jpg. Alright, and then here in my HTML file I'm going to go ahead and in this div box, I'll add an image tag where the source is equal to images/puppy.jpg. And let's reload. And there it is. Okay. So far we've just done some straight HTML. Let's implement a simple checkbox where if you click the checkbox, it shows the puppy, and if you unclick the checkbox, it hides the puppy. And I'm going to either show or hide this entire content block. So let's go ahead and put a checkbox here. Input type equals checkbox. And then let's start out with it checked, because we're going to start out showing the content. So there's our little checkbox. And what we want to do is, if I uncheck this, I want this to be hidden. And if I click it again, we want it to be shown. So in order to hook this checkbox up to this content div, we need to add some JavaScript. And the actual connection between the HTML and the JavaScript is going to use something called the document object model, which we're going to cover in much more detail later on in the course. But for now, what you need to know is that all of this content is inside of a document object that's accessible to JavaScript. So if I go F12 and get to the console and I type document, I have this object which has some properties, including more more document object model objects, like the head and inside the body is a div and so on and so forth. And all of this is accessible inside of JavaScript. Now, one call that I can use that's pretty easy is called, there's a method called getElementById. And that's a method of the document object. So if I have a div box with an ID of content, I can say document.getElementById content. And that returns this div tag. And inside of there is the image. So that's how I would get the div element. And let's store that in a temporary variable. Now, if I want to hide it, I can change a style property on this div box. So temp dot style, and the thing that I want to change is the display. So by default, temp.style.display is empty, which means it just shows up like it is now. But if I change that to none, it goes away. And if I set it back to empty, it appears. So that's how I can hide or show this div box, by changing the value of this property. And the other thing that I need to know is how to actually run some JavaScript code when the checked state of this checkbox changes. So every time I click on the checkbox, that generates an event. And what I want to do is write a piece of JavaScript code that responds to that event. There's a couple of different ways to do that, but what I'm going to do for now is I'm going to add an onChange attribute to this input. And then what's going to happen when this onChange event occurs is it's going to call a JavaScript function. Now, we're going to talk about functions in more detail next week as well, but for now, it's just a labeled chunk of code. And this one I'm going to call checkChanged. So this is just a call to a function called checkChanged that passes in no values. And then I'm going to define this checkChanged function up here in the head. So here's a script tag, and inside I'm going to create a function, checkChanged, like so. So for now, I'm just going to console.log gotChange. So every time I change the status of that checkbox, I should get a line in the console. So reload and click. And you see every time I check it, I get another copy of this line. And it doesn't show the line over and over again. It just adds to this number here. So now we know what we want to do. The only part that's left is if this thing is checked after the change, then we want to show the content. And if it's unchecked after the change, we want to hide the content. And so we're going to use an if statement to do that. So first, let's create a variable called checkbox. And we're going to store the document object model object for that checkbox in this variable. So document get element by ID checkbox, because that's the, and actually we need to add an ID here so that this will work. So let's go ahead and add an ID, and let's call this puppy checkbox. Just so it's a little clearer. So this ID here is going to let me get that tag and store it in this local variable. And then this content I already have as an ID. So let's call this puppy content instead. And then I'm going to do the same thing here. So there's my puppy content. And then if checkbox.checked, then I'm going to do one thing. Else, I'm going to do something different. So if you're only executing a single statement as part of this if statement, these curly brackets are optional. But if you have two or more statements, you have to show where that block of statements starts and ends using these curly brackets. And it's a good idea to include them anyhow, even if you're only putting a single line in here, because later on somebody might change the code, might add additional logic. And if you have the curly brackets there already, you minimize the chance that somebody is going to mess up. So I'm going to include the curly brackets, even though I'm only going to do one thing. So if the checkbox is checked, that means we want to show the puppy content. And so that's going to be div.style.display is empty. And if the checkbox is not checked, this else gets executed. So we're going to set div.style.display to none. And that should be it. So I'm going to go ahead and reload. And it starts out checked. So I'm going to uncheck it. And it goes away. And I check it. And it comes back.